Greetings and salutations, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Arcanum of Steamworks and Magic Obscura. Previously, we successfully managed to talk our way out of the town of Shrouded Hills and managed to get paid for crossing the bridge, at which point, unfortunately, we were violently attacked by a gnome, a fellow that we'd met previously. As it turns out, the people who are trying to kill us are doing so because I managed to survive the crash of the IFS Zephyr, and they're concerned that Radcliffe, the gnome who gave me that ring, seems to may have spoken to me. Frankly, I wish he'd told me a little bit more about this situation, now that I have bloody assassins on my trail. But in any case, now that we can leave the town, we can take the opportunity to travel. Well, we can move a little bit further away from the map so that we can activate the world map. Yes, we can take the opportunity to travel to Dernholm, capital of Cumbria. Cumbria would be the kingdom. Now, from what I understand, we do have a package to collect from Dernholm, so at some point we'll have to return to Shrouded Hills. But we also need to locate the daughter of Bessie Toon, the ghost in the cursed Shrouded Hills mine. Oh dear. Ah! Pigs! Not pigs! I thought I put you back into fast tempo. Right. Okay, well let's beat the crap out of some pigs by hand then. So disappointing.
I've been seriously hurt, sir. Please help me.
Yeah, so fatigue restore. Ah, potions. And yeah, not the Shrouded Hills gate key. Right, let's give Virgil some assistance. Hey, Virgil. I've really got to get you a better weapon at some point. I've really got to get me more bullets. Yay. I'm so bad at combat. This is embarrassing. Alright, sorry about that, Virgil. Shall we just... let's just rest for a minute. Sorry, I know the magic doesn't really take due to my technological aptitude. Let's just get to Dernholm. Oh. It's actually a fairly long journey. And if I compare... oh, no, once we're here... ah, the path to Dernholm. Well, if we just check our journal for a moment... we arrived on January the 1st... oh, we actually crashed on New Year's Day, 1885. It is now the 22nd. Good lord, we've been travelling for just over 3 weeks. Dernholm, yeah, everything is boarded up, doors are locked, it's not great. And, wow, things are so bad they can't even keep their statues stood up straight. I think it's a newspaper. Let's take a look at the... what's out of it? The Tarantian, the best source of newsworthy items in Arcanum. Councilman urges war on Caladon. I'm from Caladon, I'm not 100% happy about that. They must be stopped before they destroy our way of life. In an impassioned and at times violent display on the floor of the Industrial Council, Councilman Brave called for nothing less than the unconditional surrender of Caladon, even though no formal declaration of war has been issued. Were the magically inclined Interrant ever to try to usurp power, as in the bloody mage riots of 10 years past, Caladon would throw full support behind them, he screamed. A monarchy cannot be trusted, much less one that embraces both magic and technology. I say annex Caladon now. And this reporter could not agree more with the sentiments of Councilman Brave. It is high time we gave those Caledonians what for. We hope at the Tarantian hope that you will join us in urging a recall of present Chairman Willowsby and establishing Brave in his place. I seem to recall Ristis mentioning that the Willowsbys were bankers. Meteorological Service Bureau of Transportation, sunny weather for the next 2 to 3 days. Lovely. Alright. Oh, that's interesting. We'll toss that in a bin when we find one. Rupert's House of Well-Worn Effects. If his well-worn effects include bullets, I'm very happy to meet him. A half-orc! Yes, what do you want? Yes, what sort of wares do you carry here? A little of this, a little of that, nothing fancy. Lots of odds and ends. Of course, a lot of it's rusty, but a little spit and polish will clean up just like new, I expect. You know, I would feel bad about how you're being reduced to running essentially a junkyard, but this whole city looks like it's, as far as I can tell, you're an upstanding member of society. Let's barter. Literally rusty hammer, rusty sword, old revolver. Wow. More revolver parts, though. Yeah, just in case. Yeah, even you won't buy the newspaper. You know, if you will take the hex dagger off my hands, fine. Feel free. There's wine. Anything else I could need here? Old gears. Railroad spike. I don't think we're going to be doing much with traps in this playthrough, but if you were a mechanic, you can create some lovely little traps you can lay down with these. As far as I can tell, there are 2 uses for a shovel in the entire game, but at least we know where we can buy one. Right, thank you, sir. Let's get a move on, see what else is around. Hello. Sorry to barge into your house. I was wondering for some directions. How do you do? Yes, I don't believe I've had the pleasure. May I ask who you are whilst I've barged into your house? My name is Sarah Toon. Pleased to make your acquaintance. Likewise, I'm sure. Are you the daughter of Bessie Toon? Yes, I am. Why do you ask? Funny story, actually. I came here because I'm trying to find a way to free your mother's ghost. Oh? And why, may I ask, are you doing that? Well, your brother is rather upset, understandably. I offered to help, and he offered me 500,000 coins as payment. My brother upset? Why, he should be happy, the dog. He got what he wanted, after all. He told me you didn't like him. Not like him? That is an understatement. Do you know what he did? He convinced my mother to sign the mine over to him, and then he sold it to those thugs in Tarant. She killed herself over that. Why did she kill herself over the mine? Her only wish was that the mine stay in our family, as it has been for more than 3 generations. It was our heritage. She often told me that she'd rather be dead than to have anyone else but a Toon run it. Can you tell me who owns your family's mine now? I can't recall offhand, but I think I wrote it down somewhere. Yes, here it is. Stanton Importers, 25 Lions Head Circle, Tarant. We head to Tarant, I suppose we can take a look into that. One way or another, we need to get that deed back. Did you know she's calling your name? Why is that? Yes, I had heard that. I don't know why. I think she realised that I was the only one she could trust. Perhaps she wishes she had come with me, or she feels that I deserted her when she needed me. I couldn't stand to watch her life being ripped away from her. Perhaps, madam, you can answer a few more questions. What was your brother's excuse for selling the mine? He concocted some story about the buyers threatening his life if he didn't sell. I think he owed them money, actually, but he would never admit it. Right, why did you move here? Frankly, it's a bit of a shithole. I mean, you know, this place has seen better times. I knew what my brother was going to do as soon as he stole the mine from me and my brother. I couldn't bear to watch. I tried to get my mother to come with me, but she wouldn't leave her home. I moved here because I had nothing. I don't even own this place. It was deserted. You're squatting it? Well, to be honest, it's as good as any other house. Wouldn't your brother help you out? I mean, he seems to be well off, although I suppose if he does owe people money. Are you serious? I would never ask for his help. Oh, pride. Lovely. It's good old-fashioned pride. You know, no, I think we're done with this for the moment. Good Lord, Sarah. Why here? This place is awful. Oh, sorry. Oh, there's a pub. Fantastic. Virgil, I think it's been a long, long travel. We should get lodgings and haven't, and just, it's a bit late to sleep, but we can get something to drink.
Spare some coin for a poor old beggar, sir.
Ah, what the hell, I've been in this. Look, the fact is, in between being raised by his family and his time committing crimes and on the lam, Jack has spent some time on the streets himself. He's not the first to give, you know, to any sort of charitable institution. Oh, balls. Okay, well, he would have given some coin there, but I accidentally clicked the wrong button.
That's a fine bottle of spirits you've got there, sir.
It would certainly lift me spirits if you don't mind me saying so. Oh, why not? Here, have a bottle. Yeah, truly a kind man. Good day to you. Well, I got it for free. Who cares? Diligence, names. Well, first things first, let's get us a room and then a drink. Speak, half-orc, or do you not know how? Do you always greet new patrons in such a manner? We don't serve your type here. Remove yourself from the premises, or I'll be forced to call the guard. Please, madam, I only wish to rent a room. It'll cost you 30 coins for one night, 5 coins more than usual, and I'll have to clean the bed to get rid of the lice I'm sure you're infested with. Yeah, I'll take a room for the night. Okay, then you'll find your home just down the hall, but you'll have use the room for tonight only. Don't be causing any trouble, or I won't hesitate to have you removed. And there's no refunds. Thanks. Hey, another half-orc. What is it? What's up, friend? No, I'm trying to enjoy my drink, and then you have to come here and bother me. I think that's very rude to you. You're going to have to be taught a lesson. I appreciate I don't actually have any bullets on me, but I seriously recommend you apologize to me, sir. Jais? To a weakling? You know it would be the day, sir. No, I think you've got this one coming. Right then, mate. This is problematic. Oh, balls. Let's just... game. This is probably going to go tits up quickly. Okay, what can we... No, it's not set off a grenade in the middle of a bar. What's that? Changing in... No, that's... No. The role player in me will not tolerate that, thank you. Right. Oh, balls! Right, I'm going to run away and give Virgil the chance to beat the crap out of him. Virgil. Oh, nope. Do pardon me. Okay, let's not start a fight with the belligerent half-orc this time. We need to go through the rigmarole of getting a room again. One moment. Okay, let's just get a drink. What does the half-orc want with me? I'm just gonna scowl at him. What can I do for you? Drink, please. Yes. Certainly, here you are, sir. Thank you. Any rumours going around? I hear that the captain of the guard, Sir Garrick Stout, is a pompous, rude bull. They say that his men fear him, but have no respect for him whatsoever. That's not so much a rumour as your personal opinion, but okay, I will take it. Thank you. Oh. Another gnome. We may want to sleep some of this off later, but for now let's a little bit of a walk around. Let's continue wandering through glass houses. Fortunately there doesn't appear to be anyone in this inn this time. Oh, okay, we found Sarah. Now we just need to find somebody who can tell us where to get that package from. Some capable guardsmen and a fellow in full plate mail armour. Oh, get on with it, Harthorpe. I don't have all day. Alright, well, screw you, sir. Castle. If there's anything worth. No, okay. Just make it a habit to check these things. Take a look at the docks. Hello? I did not associate with half-orcs. Well, that was rather rude. I'd like to ask you a question. There were a great deal coming. I'm sorry, madam. I'm standing on you. Is there anything else going on here? Have you met Janus Stiles? Poor girl, living all alone the way she does, and always studying her books. Says she wants to be a healer. Oh, really? Well, thank you. I am grateful for that. Farewell. Here, no. Hello, sir.
Yeah, what is it?
I don't appreciate your tone.
Yeah, well, Archibald J. Sloane doesn't care what you do or don't like.
Right, well, pardon my intrusion. Look, I just mean to ask some questions.
Never you mind, then.
Hello, sir. I'm asking some questions. What do you think? I would wish to speak with a half-orc. Please excuse my presence, sir. I mean no offence. I suppose you're an alright sort. What can I do for you? Well, frankly, I was going to ask you some directions, but whilst I'm here, I suppose there's any work around? Hey, you daft man. Look around you. Dernholm is dying. There's not enough work here for citizens, let alone a drifter. Oh, well, thank you. I'll be on my way then, shan't I? Are you sure? What's your name, sir?
Oh, Burnham.
I work at the docks here. What little work there is. This. Yep. there is a quest here, but I can't seem to get it. Hello. Let me ask you some questions. Anything going around here?
I was wandering northwest of here and I found an ancient maze, or at least the ruins of one. I heard some strange noises and got out there quick.
Oh well, thank you very much. You can entertainingly just ask people generally about anything that might be going on in the area. It's quite nice. It'll give you hints and pointers towards potential quests. Noblewoman. You must be lost. You must be lost, half-orc. You're not welcome here. I say, madam, you can't be speaking to me. I'm sorry, but I have very little time for someone with your inferior qualities. I recommend you go on your way, sir. Madam, please, can't we act more civilly to one another? I suppose I might be able to tolerate speaking with you for a few moments. Thank you. Might I ask who you are? My name is Leanna. Greetings, Leanna. I'm looking... Do you mind if I have a few moments? I just need to ask some questions. What can I help you with? Well, frankly, I'd like to talk to you about where I can find this package, but also, what is going on here? What would you like to know? Okay, so what is with Dernholm?
Dernholm? Dernholm was once the greatest city in all of Arcanum, and Cumbria its greatest kingdoms. Things have changed much since, well...
What? Since what?
Since King Praetor came into power. His father, King Torrhen, was a great king and brought much glory to Cumbria. but he died during the war with Tyrant, and things have never been the same.
Why? What has happened?
Many years ago, King Torren outlawed the use of technology within the city walls. Our defeat by Tyrant showed us the error of those ways. We buried a great king because of it. Unfortunately, Praetor came to power. The throne wasn't even his to take.
What do you mean? Wasn't Praetor the son of King Torren?
Yes, but he wasn't the firstborn. I'm sorry, but these things are forbidden to speak of. I've said too much already.
I see. Well, tell me about the war with Tyrant.
The war with Tyrant? It was so many years ago. From what my father told me, the dispute was over land. What else do kingdoms ever fight over? It didn't really matter. Cumbria was strong, and the Industrial Council had just come into power in Tyrant. It was only a matter of time before things came to war.
What happened?
It was a terrible battle. The Dragon Knights were called upon to defend Cumbria, and as always, they heeded the call. My father told me of that day. The knights upon their war steeds, dressed in armor of gold and silver. The trumpets sounded, and they charged. They charged, wave after wave of the finest soldiers that Arcanum has ever known. Charged directly into the bullets fired by the Tyrantian foot soldiers. The Dragon Knights never stopped, not once. My father said the piles of the dead were like great metal mountains rising from oceans of blood. It was a massacre.
Not surprising if they charged into a rifle barrage, but okay. Who was your father?
My father was Warren Peldar. He was captain of the Dragon Knights and the greatest warrior I have ever known. From when I was very young, he taught me the ways of the Dragon Knights, and he taught me to love Cumbria, to hold the memory of her former greatness in my heart.
Well, where is he?
He's dead. He died 10 years ago. He was an old man, but I think his spirit died many years before. My father loved Cumbria more than anything, and seeing what the kingdom became broke his very heart.
So who were the Dragon Knights?
The Dragon Knights were the soldiers elite of Cumbria. Only the most skilled were chosen for their ranks, and only the most noble of those. They were feared throughout the land, and they were revered here in our kingdom. My father, he told me many stories about them, about their strength and bravery, and he was the finest amongst them. A few more general questions. Tell me about yourself, Liana.
What's to tell? I'm Cumbrian. I love my country. I would fight to the death for it, using all the skills that my father taught me. I can only hope that someday I am as great a warrior as he.
So, you are a warrior. And what skills do you have?
My father taught me many things, but I've always been very proficient with throwing weapons. Knives, axes, whatever is at hand.
I see. Well, thank you for your time. I'm sorry that I couldn't help more. What's over here? Dolan's General Store. Think. It's ringing a bell. Oh. More crap out here. We're able to scavenge. Nope. Okay, that'll work.
Yes, hello. You must be Mr. Dolan. Get on with that, half-orc.
Well, that was uncalled for.
What do you want?
Whilst I'm here, do you sell bullets?
Oh, you do. You dick.
Sorry. Pardon, gentle viewers.
But I am somewhat frustrated by his, overcharged prices. Lockback.
So I'm here to pick up for something for Jungle Dunn.
Ah, old Jungle Dunn. Sent word you'd be showing up, friend. I have his package right here. That wizard is just a crazy old man.
Thank you. What sort of wares do you carry here?
Just look around, sir. Our specialty here is reasonably priced wares at excellent value.
We stock common items, a little of everything you might need. Let me know if I can help you.
I suppose you've improved your attitude any by interacting with you like that?
No.
Wonderful. There might be a blacksmith around here. There's a fair chance they can do me a better deal than that. I'm really considering putting up some points in haggle, actually.
Ah, Wallow's quality armor. Ooh.
Rubbish bin. Nope. Okay, no revolver parts. I don't care for your kind, half-orc.
Right. Shall we barter, good sir?
It's not looking positive. Yep, no. No, they hit me here too.
Studded leather, it's yours for just 40 1.5 grand.
Lovely.
I'm sorely considering buying you a sword, Virgil, but maybe not from here. Right, we need more money. Let's ask around and see if any of the guards have heard any opportunities in the area. Come with a half orc, I don't have all day. Yep. But may I ask you some questions, sir? Yeah, what is it? Who's in charge around here? That'd be Sir Garrick Stout, or Sir Garrick Stout, as he insists on being called. You don't seem to think highly of him. No, I'm not the only one. The pompous brute is not regarded, highly regarded by many. Of course, you didn't hear that from me. Yes, farewell. This gentleman, in fact.
Stand fast, sir! You have the honour of addressing Sir Garrick Stout, Captain of the Dernholm Guard and Master of Melee. What say you, citizen?
Sir Garrick, I have a question.
My duties be calling. Be quick and do not waste my time with frivolous matters. Really, sir, I don't have time for such common trivialities. Bother me no more.
Ah, you dick. Right, okay then. Oh, some of the alcohol is worn off. I might just take another look at a fellow in here. I swear there was... Excuse me, sir. Right. I'm just going to pause the recording for a moment. Be right back.
It is done.
Okay. Never mind. Just testing something. Let's just take a little bit further of a walk around the town. Frankly, at this point, yeah, we could use a little bit of work. We're running low on... We're not exactly running low on money, but I want to be able to afford, or perhaps just acquire, a sword. Something better than a rusty dagger for Virgil here. Oh. Hello. Look, I'm looking for work. Is there anything I might be able to help you with? I wouldn't wish to burden a stranger with my troubles. Well, that's been good, because speaking with you is burdened enough. Please tell me, perhaps I could help. The family heirloom has been stolen. The silver ring that belonged to my grandmother. Okay, well, when did you last see the ring? I entrusted it to my son before he died. When did he die? 20 years ago. I lost both him and my husband to the plague. I've been alone ever since. Okay, so you've lost this ring for 20 years. Who else could I talk to about your son? A man named Archibald was friendly with my son before he died. I think I recognise that name. At the risk of it being the same truculent gentleman, how can I find this Archibald? He's living down the docks, last I heard. Well, I'll talk to him again, I suppose. Perhaps he knows something. Thank you, kind sir. Yes, yes. Right, well, let's talk to that moron. Who cares about streets? I'm going to run through alleyways between buildings. Ah! Okay. Right. Yeah, what is it? Archibald, a lady, Gladys, sent me to talk about a ring.
Gladys, tell that old hag I'll never give her the ring back. Never! If you come by here again, I'll have my son Bernard give you a sound thrashing.
I cannot believe you would be so cruel to an old lady, sir.
Leave my home immediately, or I'll call my son Bernard, you hear me?
You're right, I'm leaving. I need to murder that man, frankly, but... Okay. Yeah. Again, was it Bernard, wasn't it? Do you mind if I ask you... Are you Archibald, Bernard? Yes, why do you ask? Gladys thinks your father might know something about a ring. Ugh, not this again. Every month or so, she finds someone to send over here to try and get that ring from my father. This is so tiresome, really. One would think they were all school children the way they would carry on. What do you mean? My sister and Gladys' son were engaged to be married some 20 years ago. Then the plague came. They both died, along with Gladys' husband. The ring she sent you here to find was the engagement ring her son gave my sister. Then why does she say it was stolen? I don't know, it's some perverse game they've been playing over the last 10 years. So you find someone to come look for the ring, my father yells at them and then sends them away. It's really the only contact either of them has with the outside world. Have you tried to talk sense into them? Yes, but I gave up long ago. My father doesn't want to hear anything about it from me. He just sits around waiting for the next fellow to come around asking about the ring so he can yell at him. Right, thank you for your time. Well, I didn't go to my father's equivalent of charm school for nothing. It's you. What do you want now? Did that old hag send you back here? Yeah, it's funny, actually. I had a conversation with your son. What did that young fool tell you? He doesn't know when to keep his mouth shut. I know what's going on between you and Gladys. But what are you implying? I want nothing to do with her, I tell you. You know, I think Gladys is attracted to you. I might have believed that some time ago, but not now. I mean, look at me. She confided in me that she was interested in you. Honestly, you think she'd talk to me if I returned the ring? You're such a revolting twit. I'm sure she'd want to show you her gratitude. Would you take the ring to tell her I'd like to talk to her? Yeah, maybe Gladys will pay me. It'll be my pleasure. Frankly, if you're trying, I feel like trying to wheedle payment out of that gentleman would probably result in pain and anguish on my part, frankly. Cutting through the rickety streets of Dernholm, no one's repaired these roads in years. King must be bankrupt. Gladys.
Hello.
I found your ring.
You did? How did you find it?
Archibald gave it to me, along with his regards.
Oh, he did. How thoughtful of him to think of me.
You should pay me your respects.
What a grand idea. I'll do that. I will do that. Thank you again, young man. Good luck.
You crazy, crazy old woman. You know what, Virgil? I know it's late, but I think after all this, we really deserve a drink and some rest. I think we should probably return to the inn and leave this till tomorrow to deal with. Let's just idly invade people's houses for a few more moments, okay? Right, let's get some, you know, the rest of the day is ours. We can rest, we can, I don't know, sing and dance, whatever it is we do. Frankly, you could try and remember more of the Pinari business to talk to me about, and, well, we'll go from there. Oh, yes, I'll have another drink, barman. Drink, please. Thank you, sir. Right, then. Let's get some rest. Hello? Who's this lady? What, are you a beggar? What is it, a half-orc?
That was rather rude. I'd like to ask you a question. Any news passed this way?
No, you didn't want to hear it from me, friend, but King Praetor wasn't the rightful heir to the throne. I'll say no more about that. Thank you, ma'am. Oh, Virgil. Rest. So glad. Let's pop this newspaper in there, though. And anything else we want to load? No. Okay. Let's get some rest, and when morning comes, we'll be right and ready to face the new day. I think, actually, if you're up for it, old chap, we might spend a little bit of time working on our skills. Okay, yeah, definitely need to sleep off the effects of that before we do any more. The day of cheer and slumber passes. Oh, right then, old chap. What are we up to? A second follower. Fantastic. Okay, so the amount of followers you can have is dictated by your total charisma. As you may have noticed, I gave Jack something of a deliberate handicap, and he started out with an especially low charisma. Nevertheless, this does unlock some opportunities for us, and we'll be able to head out and investigate those soon enough. Oh, fantastic. This is, this is level 5. Every, can't raise that yet. Every fifth level, you get 2 points to upgrade yourself instead of 1. So, although it's not too useful for us just yet, soon enough we'll have enough points to raise our persuasion again. After all, it is important to be a gentleman wherever one can. Do I want to increase anything else? Sooner or later we need explosives, but not just yet. Okay. Ugh. I think we continue to investigate. I'm going to take this opportunity to have a little bit of a break, and we will continue on from here, and perhaps see if there's anything we can do with the King of Cumbria.